Minecraft is single-handedly one of the most popular games in the world, and with success comes some really bad ripoffs. For example, Mini World Block Art. This ripoff is a free-to-play Steam version of Minecraft, and has zero shame whatsoever when it comes to the similarities. Everywhere you go in this game, it does exactly what Minecraft does, but it just has a different name for it, like how stone is called rock, or dirt is called soil. It is super weird, like of all things to avoid copyright, you change stone and dirt? There are a lot of things we could compare, but we'd be here all day because it's literally a fake Chinese Minecraft. However, it actually has some things that Minecraft doesn't have. Instead of having to join servers for custom modes, you can actually look for mini games right on the home screen. People make and share thousands of their own fun games, and it is really neat, I gotta admit. It even has things like a terrain editor and ways to make your own vehicles like a fighter jet. I mean, Minecraft could do these with mods or talented server developers, but Mini World lets you do it straight out of the box. Not gonna lie, for a free game, I'm kinda impressed. But even Mini World isn't as blatant as Realmcraft. If you have ever opened up the App Store and looked for Minecraft, you've probably seen this game advertised right next to it. Of course, I'm talking about Realmcraft 3D. Out of all the games on this list, this is definitely one of the most blatant ripoffs. I mean, not only because it has craft in the name, but because if you look at their YouTube channel, they literally put Minecraft in the title for their tutorials. I mean, look at that, free Minecraft life hacks, hashtag Minecraft tutorial, it's just hilarious. But despite this, a lot of people actually love Realmcraft. It's free and it's practically a clone of Minecraft with a few different designs and stuff. It's basically a resource pack, but that's what it does best, copying. It is riddled with microtransactions, but then again, so is Bedrock Edition. And so not everything has to be a cookie cutter copy like Realmcraft is. There are actually some really creative games out there like Ace of Spades. If you were playing Minecraft back in the early days, like 2012 or 2013, you probably heard about Ace of Spades. It practically took the hype of Minecraft and turned it into Call of Duty, and they did it so well. This game was absolutely awesome. It took the blocky style of Minecraft and the digging and building mechanics, and then just made it into a first-person shooter. I mean, if I told you about a shooter game where you could build, you'd probably think of Fortnite, let's be honest. But Ace of Spades was truly one of the first to do it. You could just place blocks down like you were playing Minecraft and use them as cover, or build yourself a watchtower in the middle of a gunfight. People went nuts for this game. When it first came out, a ton of people were playing it, but obviously left Minecraft completely unshaken. Despite that, Ace of Spades eventually died out over the coming years, and a lot of players left when the new updates changed how the game worked. And then, unfortunately, in 2018, the devs announced that they were abandoning the game. They took it off sale immediately and shut down the servers a month later. What a wild story. But if you want a Minecraft copy you can actually play now, there is Fortress Craft. And this one is the OG ripoff. It released all the way back in 2011 when Minecraft was only getting popular, and then it became the 7th best-selling title on the Xbox 360. It was huge back in the day, where it became the highest grossing indie game on Xbox Live when it released. It was so big at the time that Notch himself talked about it, and he said that it was an obvious attempt to take Minecraft and clone it as closely as possible. But then he said he thinks it's important that people are allowed to do things like that, but he didn't think that Fortress Craft was graceful. And then it got really dramatic when the devs of Fortress Craft replied, saying that nobody will pay for Minecraft when they can pay $3 for Total Miner or Fortress Craft. A lot of drama over here. And eventually though, this whole feud ended when Mojang said that they were bored with the Minecraft clones, but wouldn't be suing anyone over it. And obviously since then, we've gotten all of these ripoffs that we're showing you today, but Fortress Craft was truly the OG. Now it was eventually abandoned when Microsoft moved on from the Xbox 360, but good news for any fans of this game, because it came back this year. Yeah, it was finally ported to Steam and people are loving it, all 14 of them. Jokes aside though, it's actually super fun. It's got modes like freeze tag, spleef hunt, even a workshop that lets you make custom blocks. It is way more focused on the building and creative aspect than Minecraft is, and that's why a lot of people love it. And I have to admit, a lot of these clones so far have been pretty good quality, but no more of that, it's time for Craft Mine. Okay, this one feels like you just can't make it up. While other games at least try to hide the fact of Minecraft clones, I mean, just look at this. It's a pretty funny thing you can find on those Flash game websites, and it's obviously the perfect clone for when you only have a browser and don't want to put up with the laggy mess that is Minecraft Classic. You can choose between these two Funko Pop versions of Minecraft, Steve and Alex, and then you get thrown into this wacky 2D Terraria looking world that works exactly like Minecraft does. There are a few extra things, like Craft Mine having a temperature bar and thirst being different from hunger. The mobs are weird, like zombies just fall from the sky, and the crafting menu has all kinds of wacky items that you can definitely only find in Flash game ripoffs. But from shameless copies to a nostalgia fest, we have Survival Craft. Of course, sticking with the craft theme here, Survival Craft, a ripoff that looks just like Minecraft from afar, but when you actually play it, it actually feels a bit different. The logo itself looks like it was made by a 5-year-old, but it doesn't matter because people love this game. Back in the day, you'd want to play old Minecraft Pocket Edition, but your parents couldn't afford it, So you got this instead. Honestly, none of us were complaining. Survivalcraft is a pretty neat Minecraft clone, and it has its own huge fan base. Plus, it has a ton of things Minecraft doesn't, like guns, modern electricity, and it's been around for a long time. But a ripoff that really took things to another level is DinoCraft. While a lot of Minecraft clones are just straight up ripoffs that do the same thing but cheaper, DinoCraft takes Minecraft and turns it into Jurassic Park. Literally a prehistoric Minecraft. It's an awesome idea and has all kinds of different biomes and dinosaur mobs. You can even tame dinos, put a collar on them, and then make them follow you around. Theoretically, you could just run around with an army of dinosaurs following you. Other than that, it's literally just Minecraft. I mean, you could just replicate this game by downloading a few Minecraft dino mods. And I mean, some clips from DinoCraft actually look like just clips of Minecraft. It's hard to tell the difference between them sometimes. And in a shocking turn of events, it turns out that DinoCraft is actually made by the same people who made RealmCraft. I mean, they really made their whole company around copying Minecraft. Kind of funny. At least they're doing well for themselves. Something that you have to see, though, is Blockheads. This next game is like if you took the Craftmine Flash game we talked about and gave it a remaster. Say hello to Blockheads, a free mobile game that is a 2D ripoff of Minecraft. Although you gotta give credit to this clone because they went all out. It has the perfect 2.5D Mario style and does take a lot of inspiration from Minecraft, I mean sure, but it also adds a ton of original things. There's advanced tech like shops, steam trains, electricity, and more. There's even portals, the ability to climb trees, it's all really cool. Although the game hasn't been updated since like 2019, it's free and on the App Store right now, so perfect for all you guys looking for a fresh, totally not Minecraft experience. While Blockheads is actually a pretty good quality clone, I can't exactly say the same for WorldCraft. There is no easy way to describe WorldCraft other than if you took the OG Minecraft Pocket Edition, downgraded the graphics back to the PlayStation 2 era, and then threw it in a microwave. It is literally the Minecraft experience exactly, but a low-quality clone. And there isn't much uniqueness to this one, especially compared to the other ripoffs out there. But, you know, it's still things to love. When you kill zombies, you can see them like float up to heaven or something, and you can literally find ghosts of animals just wandering around. It's all kind of weird. Not to mention this weird pumpkin-looking guy. But even if you thought that this was the worst and weirdest Minecraft clone, I haven't even gotten to our next entry, which is Castle Miner Z. Which has got to be the worst Minecraft clone out of all the games on this list. And surprisingly, it's actually the most expensive. This thing costs $4 and is absolute chaos. I mean, I do kind of love how chaotic this game is, though it's literally Minecraft, but with every kind of feature you think of adding. Now, it does feel like the devs of this game just wanted a Minecraft clone, but to avoid copyright, they also ripped off every other game in existence. I mean, this thing has 3D modeled machine guns, AKs, sticky grenades, dragons, meteors. It's also fully blocky like Minecraft, but all of your items are perfectly modeled things, so you're just some dude in a Minecraft world fighting Satan with a fully fleshed laser rifle. It's very weird. Now, I spent a ton of time playing this one because I was trying to figure out how to describe it. When I said it's the worst Minecraft clone, I mean, it doesn't mean it's bad, it's just really weird and wacky. It's also got really dated gameplay because this thing was an Xbox 360 game. Yes, it is practically 10 years old at this point and is still fun as ever. I mean, you used to log on to your Xbox 360 dashboard, look for Minecraft, and instead all you get was this. And people would love it. And the craziest part is that the devs are still updating it as far as 2018. Well, that's it for our Minecraft clones video. Thanks so much for watching. It's been Tommy, and keep it here on T5G.